On the issue of blockchain and Bitcoin, I need to make it very clear here. The central bank has never made any statement, you know, telling the public that they should not use Bitcoin or they should not use blockchain. It was just a caution because it's a new area. As we speak here, I have listened to a lot of presentations on blockchain. And with all humility, I keep still saying it, that we are all reading the internet, you know, publications. Nobody here can tell me that he has implemented one distributed ledger or has Zoom blockchain working. We are all reading materials and we are interpreting it to the best of our knowledge. Why? Because we want to caution ourselves. Now, there are a lot of people in this country today that are holding Bitcoin and other currencies. And the question is, who regulates it? One of the number one concerns of the central bank is when it comes to consumer protection. Now, we've had a situation, I read on the internet of several cases, you know, in which some people created the Bitcoin wallet. As a matter of fact, when you create the Bitcoin wallet, your public key, which is the only way by which you are identified, is a very long string, I think about 30 characters, very long chain. You can't put that on your brain. Okay, I can't put it on my brain. I don't know about you. And so it means you have to write it down. And when it is written down and it's stolen, your wallet is gone. If you lose it, your wallet is gone. And if your wallet is gone, there is no recovery. And you cannot come to any regulator. Because why? There is no middleman. This is so from consumer protection perspective, we are of major concern. Blockchain is a technology that enables, you know, decentralizing of assets. I like to put it that. And I central bank is very happy that this technology is coming up because we recognize the fact that, you know, we need to democratize our resources. And that is the major founding principle of the blockchain, that things have to be democratized. Nothing is going to happen just within some few people. Everybody has to be aware. So take a bank, for example, Bank A. All its customers will have to be aware of how money is being moved. If I move my money from my account to another person's account, everybody in that bank has to keep a record of what I have done, which is very transparent, understood. When this issue of blockchain came to CBN, we did our research. We contacted our partners, you know, some of our development partners. We contacted some other countries to see their own position and to understand exactly, you know, how they want to handle it. And what we have done so far is to constitute a committee that is basically looking, you know, at the various use cases. Central Bank has not set up a committee to look at how to stop the frauds or how to mitigate, you know, the resultant or the derivatives of the blockchain. The committee basically is looking at the use cases, in which areas can it be used. And when you identify the various use cases, then you develop framework or guidelines to guide the participants. As a matter of fact, implementing cryptocurrency on blockchain is just one of the derivatives, it's just one of the use cases. Bitcoin is just one of the use cases of blockchain. There are several use cases. And a lot of people have actually said you can maintain, you know, digital assets on blockchain, not necessarily currency. Yes, there had been, you know, a public conception that when cryptocurrency comes to stay, then the central bank or the central regulatory body will no longer have, you know, its relevance. And I heard there was a joke here too that when cryptocurrency comes to stay or when blockchain is fully implemented, NIBS may probably not have a job again, or that company may go into extinction. That is the public perception. But that's not going to be. That's not going to be. Because whether you like it or not, people are going to participate in the activities, you know, of financial transaction. We may not be the institution controlling the issuance of the digital currency. Now, that's a major concern. Because digital currency has no central issuing authority. Blockchain, for example, has no issuing authority. As a matter of fact, there is no entity called Satoshi Nakamoto. It's just a pseudonym. It's just a pseudonym. That's all. The guy is alive. He may even be in this room. But he does not. Yeah, it's just a pseudonym. The technology is there and is there. About 20 years ago, you know, when the issue of internet during the dot-com boom, a lot of people didn't believe that the internet was going to take over our life. Today, everybody in this room, I can bet 99%, that everybody in this room is holding a smartphone. A smartphone that has data that is connected to the internet. In other words, all of us are participating on the World Wide Web activities now. Is that your phone is receiving email now, or is probably sending an email? Or is basically receiving a chat message? A lot of activities are actually happening. So it has come to stay. Internet has come to stay. And today, nobody owns the internet. Nobody. Nobody owns the internet. We all connect our systems as nodes to the internet and becomes the internet. So the same way, nobody's going to own the blockchain technology. It's a technology that all you need to do is to look at it and ask yourself, how can I put my business on blockchain in order to achieve the objective that I want to achieve? And one of the popular objectives is about the transparency and the security of the blockchain. Because it's been described as a platform upon which you can implement your business, and you get the maximum encryption and protection for all the digital information that is flowing because of the nature of the way that it's been built, cascading transactions, joining them together in such a manner that every single transaction in there has its own identity, unique identity, such that if a hacker or an infiltrator actually comes in to infiltrate a particular node, you can only destroy that node. You can't destroy the many nodes and many participants and wallets that are being held. And when reconciliation comes to stay, you at the end of the day, again, they will reconcile and confirm that this is actually the right information. So central bank is open to a lot of discussion on cryptocurrency and blockchain. And that's why we have set up a committee now. And I'm sure in a few weeks, they will actually come back to us to identify the various use cases and which one that the central bank should focus on now. So central bank has not come to criticize or debunk the usefulness of blockchain. It's a technology that has come to stay. What we're concerned with is the different use cases. In which area can the government use it? In which area can our financial sector use it? In which area can the health sector use it? In our payment system Vision 2020, as part of our campaign and strategy to foster electronic payment and cashless society, we identify about 8 industry verticals. And those are the areas that we actually want to push our campaign. Transport, health, government flows, smart city, and several other initiatives. Now, these are areas that we also want to ask ourselves, could we use blockchain to push these initiatives? Currency, there are several currencies. There are up to about 20 different currencies, cryptocurrencies that have been implemented on blockchain. It's just that the most popular one is Bitcoin. Like I said, what Central Bank has done is to set up a committee, an industry committee, not just Central Bank, but all the various stakeholders, to look at the various use cases. Use cases as to what kind of businesses, what kind of transactions, what kind of flows and agreements, assets that can be placed on blockchain. It's a technology that has come to stay. It's just a network technology, distributed technology. Right now, majority of our systems are centralized. All our banking systems are centralized. Everyone is connected to one center. And so we are not averse to it. So we have set up a committee to identify those use cases. Central Bank of Nigeria is participating in a West African project called the West African Monetarism Zone Project, the WAMZ, in which the West African countries are looking at how they can do trades across within the zone such that we use one unified currency. So it's a use case upon which we can do that. And that's why that committee has been set up. We expect the committee to come out with a white paper that basically spells out the general view. And then secondly, a recommendation in terms of the various use cases. And then once we identify the use cases, then Central Bank will take each use case and put a guideline or a framework so that anybody who wants to use blockchain, with this particular use case, this is the guiding principle upon which all the participants will work together. And that's basically the role of Central Bank, to make sure that all the participating agents can work and interoperate seamlessly without a lot of risk being introduced. So that's what we expect out of the committee, and very soon the committees will be done. Now, a lot of people have signified their interest to be part of that committee, and that's why I've been meeting quite a number of them to get their details so we can invite them to come and join and help us enrich the discussion you know, on a blockchain. We've also encouraged and sponsored another discussion on fintechs. Just a week ago, we called major hubs, major startup, you know, businesses in Nigeria, and fintechs to come together and discuss with Central Bank, and let's see how we can use innovation to solve majority of the economic and financial problems that we have in Nigeria. So Central Bank actually encourages techies, you know, guys that are very innovative, to come out of their shell, and let's know how Central Bank can help. If there are barriers in terms of regulation that is, you know, stopping them from approaching us or from investing in some of the good initiatives that is happening, you know, around the world, we are ready to discuss those barriers. If the regulation is too harsh, we are ready to discuss some of the controls, you know, that they think is a barrier for them to come up. And that's why we had that discussion. So Central Bank is very open, knowing that whether we like it or not, blockchain has come to stay and is actually going to be, you know, the future technology upon which financial transactions, you know, happen.